Now I'm going to show you how to assemble a Fogg dairy valve. First, I'm going to start with a vent tube. Then I'm going to put this O-ring around the bottom, such as this. Next, I will take my CIP-able sleeve and I'll put what's called a flip-flop seal around here. And there is a little track for this to actually sit in, so it sits, so it doesn't sit flat like a rubber band. It actually fits around in a little groove. Then I take my vent tube, I slide it through the sleeve all the way down to the bottom. Then I take what's called a keeper plate and I line it with, there's a slot right here and a tab where it locks right in so it can't move. Then after that, take my spring and I take my CIP-able adapter. When you align it, you'll have a track for a pin and then you have a vent tube retainer. They all have to be lined up. So the vent tube retainer goes, it just snaps right on, but the way it has to set is there's a hole for the pin and the vent tube retainer has to be able to slot for that pin. There's slots on these where their sides are flat. You actually drop it in flat, rotate it 180, then the other flat side drops in. So now it's locked in, it can't fall out. Then you have your locking gasket. Then your clamp that attaches it to your bowl. You have a drip deflector, which this is also goes in with an orientation to it. So this has, if you can see it, a little slot right here. There's another tab on this. So you put it in, rotate it over, it locks into place. So now this can't move, so when you put your valve in your bowl, any liquid coming out always diverts out the back. Then you have your overflow chamber with your overflow spacer. Put your overflow spacer in there. You kind of have to just work this. You get the feel for it once you do a couple. But you just work that around, that locks in, and now you have a functioning valve.